Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I'm really excited for today's video because it's been highly requested. I've gotten so many messages on Instagram and also on YouTube asking if I could create an Everlane blazer review guide. So this video is going to be a review of three Everlane blazers. Two of them are their like most popular ones. And then the last one is a newer one that's coming out, and I wanted to give you guys a sneak peek and review of that blazer. Next week I will have a video up which is going to be 30 different ways to style these three Everlane blazers. So it's kind of like a capsule wardrobe video. If you want to see 30 different outfits with these three blazers, make sure to check out my video next week. So the three blazers that I'm going to be reviewing in today's video are the Everlane Oversized Blazer. This one is super popular. A lot of people have this blazer. It's their Glen plaid one, but it also comes in a couple of different colors. The second blazer I'm going to be reviewing is the Everlane Oversized Linen Blazer. This one is also very, very popular. And then the very last blazer that I'm going to be reviewing is the Everlane Boss Blazer. This one is the one that hasn't been released yet, at least as of this video, but it might get released by the time I post this video. Sorry if you guys hear a trash truck. There's one coming right outside my place right now, so you might be able to hear it. So the Everlane Boss Blazer and the Everlane Oversized Linen Blazer, these two were very kindly sent to me by Everlane, so I just wanted to disclose that up front. Alright guys, so the first blazer that I have here is the Everlane Oversized Blazer. This blazer, this particular one in this Glen plaid pattern, retails for $180. It does come in four other colors as well, so I think there's a black, this one, and then a brown, black, like, window pane looking one, and then I forget what the last color is, but there's four different styles, or four different colors, and I think the solid ones are a little bit cheaper than this Glen plaid one. Come in lots of different standard, you know, Everlane sizes, so like 00, I think all the way up to like 14 or 16. And for reference, I'm 5'2". I did get this in a 00. I really like this blazer. It's super popular. A lot of people have it. And I just think it's really versatile. So especially in this Glen plaid color, it works with everything. If you go on my Instagram, I have a lot of outfits with this blazer on. And this blazer does feel quite substantial, but it's not thick. So it's not super heavy, and when you put it on, it doesn't feel very like heavy or weighted. It's just like a nice warm blazer, like a nice little layer that you can put over any outfit. It does have like some shoulder pads here, but they're pretty thin. They're not super thick shoulder pads, so they're not going to make you look super bulky, which I really like. This one does have, you know, like classic lapels here, and then it's a two-button blazer, and then it has flap pockets here. So very classic looking blazer. This one, like the name suggests, is an oversized blazer, so I find that it's more of like a boyfriend fit, which I personally really like. I love like oversized boyfriend fit blazers because they look really great with jeans, but you can also wear them with leggings if you wanted to try and dress it down a bit, but just a lot of different ways to wear them. And then they also look really cute distressed boyfriend jeans, and then, you know, roll up the sleeves a little bit. So I just find that boyfriend blazers are really versatile, very easy for the office, but also very easy if you just want to use it as like a light jacket on the weekends. So yeah, I absolutely love this blazer. This one is, I think it's like 63% wool and then 37% nylon, something like that. It's like 60-30 wool and nylon. So for it being like 60% wool, it is quite soft. It doesn't feel scratchy at all, so I really like that. And overall, I just think this one is a really great blazer. Now, the one thing that I will say is that when I tried to put like a cashmere sweater under this blazer, it was a little bit tight, and it was tight like in the shoulder area, so if you do this movement, you feel like a little bit of tightness there. But I tried the size 0 and it was just, you know, clearly too big. So that was a little bit of a bummer for me, I guess, but it just depends. If you don't really wear anything thick under your blazers, I think you'll be okay. I mean, you could still put a cashmere sweater under this. It just does feel a little bit tight. Sweaters that I found to work best with this blazer are merino sweaters. I have two merino sweaters from Uniqlo. It's like they're 100% fine merino crew neck sweaters, and those ones are so thin but so warm, and they work really well under blazers. So if you guys are looking for some good sweaters to go under blazers, I'd highly recommend just, you know, extra fine merino extra fine merino sweaters. So yeah, I absolutely love this blazer, and I think this is just a really great staple blazer to have in your wardrobe. Okay, so next up is the oversized linen blazer. This blazer retails for $145 and also comes in a few different colors. So this one is the soft rust color, and it's their newest one that was just released. They also have a really pretty kind of like a chambray blue color, and I think they have a black and a bone color as well. But I really liked this rust color. I think it goes with so much in my closet. I actually have an older one from Gap from like 10 years ago, and then when I saw this one come out, I just had to have it because I thought it was such a great, like, updated version of the one that I currently own. And I really like this one because it is lighter weight, so you can wear it in the spring, summer. And it has that, like, oversized fit that I love. So, this one, as the name suggests, is made out of linen, but it's a linen blend, so it's not 100% linen, and it is oversized as well. So similar to the oversized blazer, I feel like these two fit very much the same, and they almost look the same. Actually, you know, I think these two are the exact same style in terms of how they're made. They're just different materials. So the other one, as you saw when I held it up, it was also like classic lapel. Oversized blazer also had a pocket here, and then both of them have the double buttons and then the flat pocket down here. I think these two are very, very similar, if not like the exact same cut, style, pattern, just in different materials, different colors. But I absolutely love the fit of these blazers. I think they are just perfectly tailored. For this one, I also got a size 00 as well. And then this one, like the oversized blazer, has a little bit of a shoulder pad in here, but it's very, very thin. So it just gives you a little bit of structure. This linen blazer, obviously, I don't think it works that well for fall, winter. I really think this blazer is a spring, summer blazer. And if you are only going to have two blazers in your wardrobe, I would say definitely pick up the oversized blazer and this oversized linen blazer, because between these two blazers alone, it will cover you for the entire year. I really love this linen blazer because I love how it drapes. It's very lightweight, and the fabric, I feel like, just hangs really, really beautifully. So when you wear it, it just looks really effortless. That's how I would describe it. I think it's just really effortless, but at the same time, it still looks very classic because the cut of the blazer, and you know, the pels, like everything, it's just very, very classic. So this one is a great one to have. For this blazer, I did get it in a size 00, and I felt the fit to be pretty perfect, except for, again, the shoulder issue. If you were to make this movement, it does get a little bit tight. And in terms of what you could fit underneath this one, definitely no cashmere sweater. When I tried it on, it was way too tight with a cashmere sweater. Blouses, shirts are good with this, and then also the merino sweaters are also okay with this one. So this one is meant to be for warmer weather anyways. I wouldn't really expect to layer any sweaters under it. But I just think, like, during transitional periods from like winter to spring or summer to fall, if the weather is a little bit cooler and you just need a little bit of an extra layer, you could definitely squeeze a merino sweater under this. All right, guys, and the very last blazer that I have here is the Everlane Boss Blazer. Now, like I mentioned at the beginning of this video, this one is not out yet as of the time that I'm filming this video, but I think when I post this in a week, this one may or may not be out. But I really like this blazer as well. Not as much as the other two, but I do really like this one. So this one is called the Boss Blazer, and it has, well, let me tell you what kind of material this is. So this one is 100% lyocell, which is the outside. The inside is polyester. I think lyocell is similar to tencel. I'm not 100% sure about that, but the fabric drapes really, really nicely on this one. This one is super drapey, and this one doesn't have as much of a like classic blazer look to it. So this one does have kind of like dropped shoulders, a little bit of a drop shoulder, and it has much smaller lapels. So this one almost kind of reminds me of like, I don't know, kind of like a tuxedo lapel almost, but except with the notches here. But it's very thin. You can see like the lapels are very thin cut. And then it's a one button blazer with flat pockets here. There is no chest pocket up here. So, you know, it's quite simple, quite minimal, and I feel like this blazer is, when you put it on, it's just a very easy, lightweight, like, lightweight jacket or layer. Of course it still looks like a blazer, but it looks very casual. I feel like this one is really, really good for the weekends if you just want to throw something like a jacket over your outfit. It works really great with jeans, but of course you can still wear this to the office because it's a blazer, but it's a lot more casual than the other two. But I do think this one is a good one to have in your closet. I really love this color, which is what attracted me to this blazer. I actually don't really like the way the lapels are. I feel like they're a little bit too thin for my liking. I like the more classic lapels of the other two blazers, but I really love this color. It's like a kind of like a grayish, like a gray taupey beige color. I don't know if it's picking up the true color on camera. It's looking a little bit lighter on camera, but it is a really beautiful color that I think works really well in the spring with a lot of neutrals. So you could pair it with like blush pink, beige, tan, nude, white. It works really, really nicely. So yeah, I feel like it's a just great lightweight jacket or layer for the spring and the summer. I did get this one in a 00. This one, I did not have the same problems I did with the other two. So I could move like this and the shoulders were not tight at all. And this one's quite loose actually. So you could squeeze quite a bit under here. And this one overall, I just find it to be a lot more relaxed than the other two. And it hits at about the same place on me as the other two do. It's not any like longer. I just feel like it's a little bit more relaxed. But overall, I do really love this blazer. It drapes really nicely. It's super casual. And it's just a beautiful color for the spring summer. I don't remember what the price of this one was. I think it's either... it's somewhere between $145 to $165. I'll have a link to this in the description box below if it's out by the time I post this video. But if not, you can just go on their website and search Boss Blazer, and then it'll come up, and I'm sure you can find all the details there. But yeah, absolutely love this blazer as well. All right, guys, so that's it for this video. I hope you found it helpful. And again, next week I will be posting a video 30 different ways to style these three blazers. So if you are looking for some spring capsule wardrobe inspiration, spring work capsule wardrobe inspiration, definitely make sure to check out my video next week. So if you guys are not subscribed, please make sure to hit the subscribe button below so that you don't miss next week's video. And I'll have these three blazers linked down in the description box below, along with my blog and my Instagram. I'm gonna have a blog post review as well with some photos of these blazers on. So if you want to see some still photos of these blazers on and what they look like, definitely head over to my blog. All right, guys, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next week. Bye.